Good afternoon from Jerusalem, Jane, sitting in the Jewish capital with a lot of noise outside my house. I literally had to close all the windows because they are very, very busy working in the construction site. I am surrounded by construction site. It's very noisy, beginning at 7 a.m. this morning. And just for me to be able to reach you, I had to close all my doors. But Jerusalem is a city in progress. They are building everywhere. And even though we are in the midst of a coronavirus crisis, they are still building. I just happen to be in the midst of it. How are you all doing? I hope you and your family are doing well in the midst of this. Here in Israel, we just had the 18 death due to the coronavirus. 4,347 people are sick as of this minute. It is escalating, not just here in Israel, but all over the world. And, you know, I'm sitting here in my home. I just made a nice spinach onion omelette. I had a cup of strawberry tea and, you know, I took a shower and I have what I need. And I am so grateful, you know, that I can sit here in safety in my home. When I read the testimonies from doctors and nurses all around the world, when I see the videos and the photos coming out from some of the hospitals and people are dying and they can't breathe and they are lying with all of these masks. So it's really, really horrifying when you see all of these scenes. And I teared up the other day when I saw the Israeli, the military in Italy driving away all of these caskets of people who have died. Absolutely heartbreaking to see what's going on. So, you know, I want to encourage you, stay safe, which means stay home. Don't go out, don't be foolish, going to the beach, or, you know, I saw someone here in Israel going hiking. It is so irresponsible. Stay home. We need to break this. We need to get on the other side of this. And the best thing you can do is to, even though it goes against our nature, to isolate, you know, isolate and stay home. And for those of you who, like me, are sitting here alone, for those of you who have a family, enjoy time with your family. You know what? For me today, it came down to the little things that, you know, I could make my food. I could take a shower. I can watch the news and keep up. I can listen to the good music, you know, that touches my soul and lifts me up. I can have fellowship with God. I opened a new bottle of shampoo today that I don't read Hebrew. I didn't know what I bought. It turned out to be an excellent shampoo for my hair. Yeah, you can laugh, but you know what? Those little things for me today, when we are sitting in this situation, I choose to be grateful. I'm grateful I'm not sick right now. I'm grateful I got food in my house. You know, I might be sitting here alone and my family is in another country. Who knows when I will see them? But right now, I'm not one of those people lying sick in a hospital and can't breathe. Or the 18 family here in Israel who have to say goodbye to a loved one. And some of them, you know, they didn't even get the chance to say goodbye because of the isolations. So stay home, stay safe. In the midst of this, Netanyahu and Benny Gantz is still negotiating to make a unity government, debating back and forth, you know, who's going to be minister for this and this and this. And now there are rumors that from the other side, Peres from the labor camp might actually join this government also. So there's a lot going on in politics. It just came out in the news that one of Netanyahu's advisors was just diagnosed with the coronavirus. So now they're trying to find out, you know, how close was Netanyahu to this lady? Will he need to quarantine? And if he quarantines, does Benny Gantz need to quarantine because he was just with Netanyahu negotiating? So yeah, that's why I'm saying for those of you who can't, stay home, stay home, stay home, stay safe. And I believe we will get on the other side of this. Everything is closed down here in Israel until we get on the other side of Pesach. They're talking about now the schools might not even open after Pesach. We will see. I was talking to my mom the other day. I'm sitting in Israel. She's sitting in Denmark. And I said, you know what? All we can do is literally just abide the rules and take one day at a time because we don't know what things are going to look like when we get on the other side of the holidays in the new months. So I'm sending so much love to you, and I just want to encourage you to take heart and stay hopeful in the midst of this. We will get on the other side. And God bless you so much. Mwah. Kiss and love from Jerusalem, Jane. Have a good day. Bye.